Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Kincade from Push, and today I'm going to teach you how to backside 50-50 coping on your skateboard. This tutorial will not focus on sliding rails or doing street features, but rather transition features like a mini ramp or a vert ramp. In the future, we will have more street style tutorials on the site, but for now, we're going to be focusing on transition. So let's jump right into it. The backside 50-50 really is not that hard as long as you have the prerequisites, which is a backside axle stall. So if you have not already watched my tutorial on how to backside axle stall, I would highly recommend doing so if you don't already know how to do the trick. If you're watching this on YouTube, I would recommend heading over to the website, and on the tutorial page, I'll have a link to the backside axle stall video. Links to the website and this specific tutorial are in the description. So anyway, you can backside axle stall. Let's talk about the backside 50-50. It's really the same concept, except for you're going to take a little bit of carve up the transition. Whereas with a backside axle stall, you're going straight up the ramp and just pivoting. The backside 50-50 actually requires you to carve a little bit diagonally up the ramp as you go into that grind, which allows you to slide the coping instead of staying stationary on it like you do in the axle stall. There are a couple common mistakes and things people struggle with when first learning this trick, and I'll try to address those now. One common issue is not locking into the coping immediately. There are a couple ways to fix this. If you're going too fast and keep overshooting the coping and going off onto the deck, either try to slow it down a little bit or try to take a more aggressive carve into that coping so that you can guarantee you lock onto it. If you're coming up short, maybe try and go just a little bit faster. Now, overall, when first learning this trick, I would say slower is better. Really just start with an axle stall and then go a little bit faster with a little bit of a carve and start to slide. Even if you just slide 6 inches your first time, that's fine. You don't need to slide the entire bowl your first go around, you know? Slow baby steps, and that will give you the feeling of really locking it in as you start that slide. Now, another common mistake that I actually struggled with quite a bit when I was learning this was feeling like you were locked in, sliding a few feet, and then feeling your board kind of go off on its own onto the deck and not stay locked into the coping. To fix that, really think about keeping your front foot locked in and keeping your body kind of facing down. Whereas on an axle stall, you can kind of get onto the coping, chill there for a minute, and kind of stand up tall. On a 50-50, you still want to keep your weight somewhat leaned into the bowl, because after you're finished sliding, you're dropping right back in. Don't allow your board to stray off onto the deck. You really want to make sure that your momentum is used to slide you around, but your weight still wants to go back in once you run out of momentum. Your wheels on the high side really should not be touching the deck, because in that case, you're really just kind of rolling along the deck with half of your board in the bowl. If your wheels are off the ground, that means that your momentum really is carrying you around the bowl, and you're doing a true 50-50, and you're not just sliding along the deck. So that is pretty much it for the backside 50-50. As you start slowing down, simply put a little bit of weight on your tail and pivot back into the transition and keep riding. If you have any questions at all, you can head over to the website, pushthelimit.com, create an account, and leave me a comment on the tutorial page there. Thanks a lot for watching, best of luck, and I'll be back soon with another tutorial.